Usually, one can divide good animes into two groups. There's one that entertains you through your emotions, scooping you up with the adrenaline-rushing fights, reventing your feelings with heartbreaking dramas, or simply tingling your adventurous sides. And then there's one that makes you sit down and think. Ponder about deeper philosophical dilemmas and questions such as those of existence, origin, and connection. Serial Experiments Lane is among the few animes to fall into the latter category. It is a fact that everyone in this world is connected. In our world, we have cell phones and the internet. There's no limit to how we can connect to each other as a fellow human. Lane, the protagonist, gets drawn deeper into such a world, the wired, realizing that this is indeed true, but on a much deeper level. Because everyone is connected with one another, not electronically, not physically, but on a deeper unconscious level. Yes, who are you really? Who am I? What is the truth behind our existence as a human? And yeah, what is indeed real in this world and what is fiction? What can be defined as reality and what is just an illusion of our minds? Or is everything merely a hallucination brought forth by our brain? And in whichever way existence functions, who or what holds the responsibility for it? For our world, a fictional world, a dream world. If you think the review has turned into a philosophical thought process straying apart from the show itself, then I would tell you this, that it does not. Serial Experiments Lane deal with all of these questions and problems. If not directly and bluntly, then it does so in a way that makes you think about it. And sometimes it's good if we are brought to think about these kind of things. Serial Experiments Lane is not your average anime. At first glance, it might look like a little bit like a Matrix movie or a Ghost in the Shell. It might even look like the genre of cyberpunk series like Bubblegum Crisis and Appleseed, and some aspects of the Cowboy Bebop lovingly ripped off from the movies such as Blade Runner and Terminator. That should not be surprising if you know the name of Chiaki Konaka, a screenwriter who is best known for The Armitage 3, The Big Zero, Digimon Tamers, Tetsu One Birdie, the original Hellsing, and 2003 version of the Astro Boy. This man is very versatile, but his forte seems to be horror and cyberpunk. I haven't seen all of his work, but I would be willing to check them out one by one. Now let's start about the review in depth. Now first, let's talk about the story of the Serial Experiments Lane. Lane's story has a lot of layers. In fact, each episode even starts out called as layer and episode number. The series is complicated and definitely not one that you can watch blindly. If you are wondering if this is trippy, complex, genre-bending and thought-provoking mindfuck anime like Neon Genesis Evangelion or Madoka Magica, then yes, it is. But in some ways, that's not intentional, nor it is a better or worse than a lot of the shows. While I personally love these shows, I would say that this is a little bit better than those. This is a series where sometimes the characters actually see more than the audience. And the narrative is definitely unorthodox. Not just for anime, but any sci-fi. You'll probably want to rewatch it once or twice in order to fully get it, like I did. But even then, it won't appeal to everyone. A young antisocial middle school girl named Lane Iwakura becomes interested in the futuristic technology surrounding them to enter a whole new world called as The Wired. And that too after her classmate Chisa Yomoda commits suicide. Lane only met this girl once, but she reaches out to her from the other side, telling her to come to the wired world. As Lane's interest in the medium becomes more intense, she is led down a path in which all the truth behind reality, identity, and how we communicate with one another are revealed to her. All of which causes her to question her own humanity. Ethical conflicts is the main focus of this series. The border between the wire and the real world isn't all that clear. The basic foundation of the storyline is sci-fi. Yet the dramatic presentation of the events which unfolds will take you into the world of the pure science fiction where the convictions of the reality are defined completely and repeatedly. Yeah, it's that kind of show. One might love it or hate it. Also one that can appeal to casual viewers and non-anime fans as well. Also definitely something computer or technology geeks would love. Next, we will talk about the animation. Despite it is 19th experimental show, I still like the art. The art is quite different from the mainstream productions. Even compared to the most popular anime shows back 15 or 20 years ago, we all know though Lane is a pretty hard to be put alongside with the mainstream for benchmark. At times, high contrast colors of different saturations grade were used to emphasize certain circumstances and moods. Weird looking reflections like intricate shadows were used to express the wide world concept. All of these things brilliantly work for creating an amazing atmosphere and is a plus point for me. Art is not the main feature of the show and there is no stunning animation to make you go wow. But you have to remember that it was created in 1998. So you can expect that kind of animation. Now let's talk about character. If anything is better than the storyline of this anime, then it is its characters. There are only a few characters that fully evolves to be true, but still the rest of the cast also develops with the equal discretion. Lane, the main character, is probably one of the well-portrayed protagonists for me in this anime. She is created with so much attention to every aspect that it's like flawless character. All the dialogues and the self-centered thinking gets viewers interested more and more to learn about her reality and always makes them guess, why is she acting like that? With every episode, Lane grows more and more until all watchers will grow into the plot progressively. Other interesting characters include Masami Eiri, who is although not a likable personality but still she is portrayed in a perfect way. Rest of the cast includes Lane's parents, sisters, her other friends and mysterious men in black, none of whom seems to disappoint either. Characters are the strongest part of the series and gets 10 out of 10 from me. Although I gave this show a 10 out of 10, I feel that it is necessary to clarify that I do not consider this show as a flawless. Don't detract us from the overall experience. For example, the pacing in the opening episode is incredibly slow, but this works in the show's favor later on as you spend more and more time trying to make sense of the event show. On repeating viewing, even the first episode no longer feels like it is dragging on, as by then it has become obvious that even minor details can be interpreted in a significant way. I like philosophy, I like fictions, even if the story is pseudoscience only, I would like to watch it. And of course, I like cyberpunk and its story backgrounds too. Yeah, if you don't know, this anime falls under cyberpunk genre. That's why this anime have all the types of genres that I love. This is such a beyond time anime in so many ways. The way the technology gets integrated in our daily life is shown in the element like the Siri-like desktop computer system, texting friends in the class, holographic display in the Lane's room, and etc. Coming from the 1998 anime, where mobile web service was not even popularized until later 2000s, this anime is beyond the time for me. Also, philosophical integrations with the technological devices is very idea-provoking. The philosophical definition of the existence and the shared collective unconsciousness are also given blue screen of death in our brains. Bad thing about this anime? Maybe the theories in this anime are too advanced for some people's and such makes some people's head explode. It's also a matter of taste indeed. I personally loved it and I give my full recommendation to anyone who likes thinking. Definitely worth watching and perhaps re-watching with your friends again. Have you watched Serial Experiments Lane? If you have watched this anime, then make sure to comment down below and let me know about your reviews, your opinions about this anime in the comment section down below. And if you enjoyed this video, just don't forget to like this video, subscribe to my YouTube channel because I post daily anime content about top 10 top 5 listings, anime reviews, recommendations, news, theories and all sort of anime content on daily basis. So if you enjoyed, please subscribe and that was it and I will see you in the next one. Sayonara.